don't want to be too bold in speaking for my brothers and sisters in religious life and in ministry. It's something we choose every day. Kind of when we get up in the morning, thank God for the gift to love Him and to serve Him and to follow Him and to tell others about Him. Two ways in the Catholic Church to be a priest. You either do it in a geographic area, like in Baltimore. You guys know Father Doug and Father Mike, priest here at St. Margaret's. Second way to do it in the Catholic Church is in religious life. Brother Jim was saying that brothers are like male nuns. In a certain sense, I get the best of both worlds. I get to live, I get to try to follow the example of St. Francis, and I get the privilege of being able to say Mass and hear confessions and preach the gospel. Briefly, about when I decided, as an aside, when I was in first grade, we had to draw a picture of what we wanted to be when we grew up. Growing up in Boston, also, a large Irish Catholic family, I couldn't decide between whether I wanted to be a lawyer or a politician. So I drew a picture of me behind a desk, supposed to be like a White House thing, and a good friend of mine drew a picture of him being a priest. He drew a picture of himself behind an altar saying Mass. And you guys have been in Catholic school probably with each other for 6, 7, 8 years, yes? You know, sometimes when you do something really dorky when you're in like second and third grade, people don't let you forget that? Yes? So for the next 8 years, I went through life calling my friend Father Fernando. And I was making fun of him for that. And so I happen to think like God has truly does have a sense of humor. It was when I was in college that I decided to be a priest. I met a Franciscan priest who was a very good example, a very holy man, and he wanted me to be holy. He wasn't necessarily recruiting me to be a priest, he wasn't recruiting me to be a Franciscan. He wanted me to be a friend of Jesus. And his example led me to wanting to pray more, to wanting to develop my friendship with Jesus. So I started going to church, started going to adoration, started devotion to Our Lady. And I remember I was at daily Mass, and this priest was preaching, and preaching, and preaching. So on like a Tuesday, regular Tuesday to ordinary time, he went on for about 25 minutes, which daily Mass should probably be about 25 minutes. And I was thinking the whole time, my God, I could do better than him. And when I actually said that aloud, it terrified me, because the people who preach in church are priests and deacons. So I started thinking, started praying, kept thinking, kept praying, and I kept getting to know the Franciscans. And eventually, when it was time to graduate, I decided that I wanted to give it a shot. So I did. I applied. I was accepted. And my hope was I actually originally entered to leave. I was hoping that after 6 months, I could say, well, it wasn't for me. I gave God my best. And go and get married, raise a family. And 11 years later, here I am. I've had, I think, the greatest days of my life as a friar. I've had some of the most difficult days of my life as a friar. But, you know, I haven't once went to bed not wanting to be one. And that's something that I'm really grateful for. I think each of us would agree that probably religious life has helped us try to become the best forms of ourselves. The best, the truest, the holiest forms of ourselves. And I really do think that if people knew how happy, how joyful, kind of so many blessings that we found in this life, I really think people would just be lining up outside the doors to join us.